What is up, guys? Welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright
Ace Attorney.
Well, last left off, we was with Detective Gumshoe investigating the evidence room. We had a roundabout way of finding everything out, but we got there eventually. I think I was recording for 40 odd minutes for a 25 minute video. But to be fair, I'll just continue on recording straight off, because I want to get this game finished. Not in a bad way. Like, I don't want to get this game finished by any stretch of the word a bad way. I'm just really pumped for my channel revamp, and I love this game, and I just want to play it until I'm done. You know, it's just like I don't want to put the game down. Like, sometimes I come back and I forget voices and stuff, which is not that great. But honestly, if I look back, I think I've not done the worst job on planet Earth on this series. You know, I mean, what do you guys think? I mean, I know I'm not like up to other certain YouTubers' standards when it comes to commentary, but I think I do an okay job, you know, to say that I'm just having a laugh with it. Okay, so there's a handprint there, so... check. Yes, can we not check the fingerprint there? Yeah. Okay, maybe I was actually backing up the right tree, just like spraying the shit out of that thing, so that doesn't work. Okay, let's do this. Can I not examine it? What's going on here? Let me look at the damn thing. This is where we got a luminal fluid reaction, right?
Right. There's a handprint here. Okay, let's try using this.
Decor eye sparkling again. Check for prints. Oh no, let's just leave it. Let's walk out. Okay, let's check for prints.
What's this, Bruce? Oh, but I have to warn you about something first.
What?
The area of the blue was wiped away, right? We really ended up finding it using chemical means. Any prints in that area will have been wiped away too.
Oh, right. So that means no prints.
What do you say the probability of your hypothesis is? Hi.
Don't ask me.
Anyway, we must try to find prints that weren't wiped away.
Prints other than the ones left by the bloody hand.
So these ones have been wiped, so what about, like, another finger? Come on, man, I'm trying to read it. I'll talk it away. I'll talk for things. Okay, let's have a look at this. No.
Is it Marshall?
Must be his locker then. That's definitely a match. Is it really true that everyone's got unique fingerprints? Like, looks like that is like really, really weird. It's like our own ID numbers, sort of like his own barcodes.
Hey, these fingerprints. Hey.
Who's that? Right? Who's? Is it someone I know?
It's Officer Marshall.
Huh? Officer Jake Marshall.
Marshall's fingerprints added to the court record.
That's gotta be a coincidence. He's not involved in the crime.
Emma. These are decidedly different from the Dave Gumshoe's prints. Luminal reaction. The blood and the fingerprints are in the same place.
Oh.
So we have Jake Marshall's fingerprints. On a wiped blood stain. Holy shit.
Why would Officer Marshall?
Looks like our investigation is finally turning some results. I guess this is what you call decisive evidence. Dun 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 dun.
I don't believe it.
You better believe it, bitch. Looks Jake Marshall's going down.
Do we continue? Da, 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 da.
Don't want to save game. Of course I want to save it.
I bang my elbow on the desk and it hurts very much.
Right. February 24th, 9:41 AM. District Court. Defendant Lobby Number 2.
So, what do you think, Mr. Wright?
I think the prosecution is as confused as we are. After all, the victim was murdered in...
The victim was murdered in two different places at the same time. And a different suspect was arrested at the other crime scene. Order! Good morning, Mr. Wright. I apologize for yesterday. I was indisposed.
I hope I didn't hold you too long for questioning.
We just finished, actually. I'm used to all matters, though. So, how'd it go? It's as Wright suspects. The police are clueless. I figured as much, so I struck a plea bargain. A plea bargain? What do you mean by that? We agreed that if I told them the truth behind this simultaneous murder, they wouldn't seek capital punishment. That's what I mean, Emma. But Lana, don't tell me you... Much to my regret. I'm as much in the dark about this as they are.
Miss Guy?
Mm-hmm.
We discovered Chase is left by a certain person in the police department's evidence room. They belong to Officer Jake Marshall.
You found Officer Marshall's traces?
His semen in the corner. Bloodstained fingerprints to be exact.
Mm-hmm.
That's a jump card I have up my sleeve today. You do understand what this means, don't you?
In order to defend my sister, you're going to accuse Mr. Marshall.
We have to play the cards we're dealt. Is that right, Miss Sky?
Do what you have to do, Mr. Wright.
Would Marshall really been doing this shit?
I don't know.
24th, 10 a.m. District Court. Court number 9.
Shut up! The judge is back in town! Betrayers and here's your bad voice! Court is now in session for the trial of Miss Lanasky.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
The prosecution is...
I'm afraid you'll have to clarify.
It takes 30 minutes by car to reach criminal affairs from the prosecutor's office. The victim, Bruce Goodman, was slain at both places at the same time.
But that's not physically possible, is it? What's more, I hear the victim from the evidence room just disappeared.
Yes, and the body eventually appeared in the trunk of Mr. Edger's car.
Wow, this is one messed up trial.
One of my duties as prosecutor is to present impartial evidence. Today I'll present evidence relating to the murder at the police department. In so doing, I believe the way in which we should proceed will reveal itself.
Now that's what set Mr. Edgeworth apart. He sounds so on top of things, even though he doesn't know what's going on himself.
That's supposed to be an admirable trait.
Very well, let the trial resume. On the day of a crime, what exactly transpired at the police department? Mr. Edgeworth, you may call your first witness of the day to the stand.
For its first witness, the prosecution calls. The suspect of a murder that occurred at the police department.
The suspect? You mean the so-called murderer?
Oh boy. Things are getting wild from the get-go.
Shut up, everyone!
It's so dopey. Will the witness please state his name and occupation?
Yes, sir. I must make it, sir. My occupation is, dopey murderer, sir.
Shorten is your professional color.
Sir, it was me, sir. I'm the one who did it. I'll never kill anyone again, sir. You gotta believe me, sir.
Actually, what we'd like to hear from you is...
Sir, I want you to call part of the younger generation, sir. Person's accusation just can't possibly comprehend.
Please, Mr. Edgeworth, sir, help me, sir.
Officer Meekins.
Yes, sir.
Give us your report of the crime. Consider that an order.
Yes, sir, as you wish. After all, I am part of a generation who must be told what to do, sir.
You can't fault them for a lack of enthusiasm.
Too enthusiastic if you ask me. Jesus, look at your eyebrows, man.
The first time I know what I was assigned a copy of evidence from that day. I spot a suspicious man on the security screen and rushed into the room. I was only what I was trained to do, sir. I was suddenly attacked. I fought for my life. Then I did it.
Aww.
I thought I passed out. Until enough for us to smack me awake.
Oh dear.
So the victim detective come and attacked you.
Don't do others before they do unto you. Mr. Meekins family matter, sir.
I see. Then you fainted and a colleague helped you regain consciousness.
Yes, sir. He knocked me upside the head, sir.
Very well. My defense may begin its cross-examination.
What I need here is more info to work with.
So let's just press him.
The crime report, sir. The crime report, sir.
Well, it's not my normal duty.
What do you mean by that? Hold it. Mr. Meekins, you work in the general first department, do you not?
Yes, sir. I'm a general firing new recruit, sir.
Yikes. Now there's a scary thought.
Evidence transfer was taking place on the day of a crime, which meant many officers were given special tasks not ordinarily performed.
I was in charge of guarding the Blue Badger, sir.
The Blue Badger?
Yes, sir. The police mascot created by head detective, sir.
Do, 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 do.
That thing is creepy as balls.
I was torturing it wasn't broken during the transferal process. That was my sole bishop of an acer.
Yes, really busy of assigning someone to protect a cardboard cutout.
I see. Sounds like a very, important mission.
I didn't want to turn my agenda. There were so many people running around. But I relocated the blue bishop to the evidence room.
Oh, so that's why I went to the evidence room.
Tell us, what did you see when you got there?
I spotted a suspicious man on the security screen, and I rushed into the room.
Okay. What is this screaming down the thing for? It's got such a huge chin, and so it's like, here comes the crimson chin. In order to enter the evidence room, you need an ID card, am I correct?
Precisely, sir. I have one right here around my neck.
So then, your ID number should be listed in here, right? Okay, it's gonna be this one, isn't it?
There it is! I found it! This is the one right here!
Could you please read us a number?
Yes, sir, it's 4989596. What's my number, sir?
I see! But the number 4989596 is showing us being used twice. Please explain, witness.
It's no real mystery, sir. The first time is when I relocated Blue Bash to the evidence room. And the second time is when I went to go get him after everything settled down.
I thought I saw a suspicious person, that's why I went in.
I see. So it was during that second time when?
Yes, sir. It was when I spotted a man on my security screen.
Oh, there we go. Is that ego? It was all known what I was trained to do, sir. Yes, it was trained to check. So you were attacked. Can you please tell us exactly what happened to you?
It was a knife, sir. A knife.
Detective Goodman pulled a knife on you? What happened, man?
Well, with me charging it on him like that, he looked as surprised as I was.
You aren't exactly the kind of person someone would want to run into.
That's when I reacted, sir. I swung my arms like an octopus, struggling to detain him. I saw a gun discussion on my hand.
Maybe if you kept your cool, your hand wouldn't be.
When I saw the blood trickling down my arm, I panicked. I grabbed the man by his collar.
You have any evidence of this? I fought for my life, and I did it. Did what?
I took a shit on the floor!
What exactly do you mean you did it?
I know I don't love the type, but I'm really into Kung Fu film, sir. The man let his go down for distance, and so I snatched a knife from him.
You took his knife?
I spun around the phone a disarming maneuver. I made sure to close my eyes like a man.
I see. He must have been desperate.
The next thing I knew, his white coat was drenched in a sea of blood, and then... The next thing I knew...
Yes?
He pushed me right in my face, sir!
Sucker punch!
I thought I passed out to the nurse this many weeks.
Hold it, what do you mean by that? About what time did you regain consciousness?
No offense, sir, but how am I supposed to know that? I was unconscious.
Oh, right. According to a report from the officer that woke up the witness, it was about 5:30.
He hit me right in the head too. I woke up crying tears of pain.
That's nice. I mean, it's nice that you recovered, that is.
When it came around though, I made sure to finish my mission, sir.
Your mission?
Yes, sir. The blue badger, sir. I returned to the entrance before things got out of hand.
Well, we can rest easy now. The blue badger is safe. Case closed. Judge Smikoyevil,
not guilty!
I believe we have a fairly accurate picture of what happened.
Yes, Your Honor. Only one thing remains unclear. What was the man this officer... Was this man the officer murdered really the victim? He's got a point.
Yes, Officer Meekins?
We've got a vote, sir. Take a look at this. It was sent to my cell. Chief Kent delivered it to me just this morning, sir.
The chief? Delivered it?
What is that? A videotape?
Yes, sir. That's absolutely right, sir. A videotape, sir. Contains footage from the security camera in the evidence room.
Objection.
What? Why Smithley asked if it was such a tape? I almost thought it had been mistakenly erased.
That's quite a mistake.
I just do what I'm told, sir. It's the only thing I'm really good at.
Looks like communication with the police department is as good as ever. Jesus, there's no communication at all.
Well then, let's have a look. Show us a video of you murdering the victim.
Oh, please stop using that word murder, sir. It scares me.
A video of a real murder. Just what are we getting ourselves into? Dun 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 dun. Oh my god. Everyone flee for your lives. It wants to devour your soul. Hello. Why would he put it in front of a bloody camera? Oh, of course. What would that fell out there? Oh, there's Meekins. Meekins. Oh my god. Oh shit. Meekins smash! Oh, that flag is so annoying. Oh wait, where'd it go? Ooh, I wasn't there before. I'm a fish!
Well, I believe we all think of the same thing. How can we deal with these unsettling feelings stirred within us?
What the hell was that wriggling piece of plywood?
Sir, that's a pain and joy being taken to the first department, sir. It's the Blue Badger, sir!
Why am I not surprised this isn't going smoothly?
Yes, well, anyway, this tape seems to prove that the witness did indeed encounter, someone. In the evidence room, and some sort of, activity did take place.
Your Honor, instead of relying on clearly incomplete footage, the witness's testimony will suffice. Is that alright with you, Officer Meekins?
Yes, sir, as you wish, sir.
Okay.
Witness testimony, mystery man.
His face can be clearly seen in the video. But there's no question that the other person was Detective Goodman, sir. I mean, he opened the locker which required Detective Goodman's fingerprints to do so. The locker he opened is in question with Detective Goodman's locker, sir. So it must be him. No one else could have unlocked it.
What's this about a fingerprint?
Each detective has been given a locker equipped with a fingerprint activated lock. These locks ensure that each locker can only be opened by the detective it belongs to.
Intriguing. That would mean the victim of the crime scene would have to be Detective Goodman. Very well, the defense may begin his cross-examination.
I don't know where his cross-examination will lead. But everything begins with contradictions. That's where I have to start. Mystery man.
But why? But they raised the point before. If it was Detective Goodman, Meekins just asked for the ID. If it was Detective Goodman and he had the ID, it would have just presented the ID, wouldn't it? I mean, why would he start kicking a foot?
His face can't be clearly seen in the video.
Of course it can't. Tommy, we don't want to go to a good look at him. Of the face of a man who attacks you with a knife.
Sir, if it was Leo Mia having seen or not seen a man's face, I believe it would be classified as the letter.
The letter? But you're standing right in front of him, are you not?
More to the point, you are the person who fought him, aren't you?
Oh yes, sir, but I didn't get a clear look at his face, sir. I'm not the kind of guy who looks directly at people when talking with them, you see?
Yeah, that's a good trait for a police officer.
So, I'm sure it was him. I'll bet my badge on it.
There's no question of who first one to take him. So, let's have a look at evidence. Let's look at this video. Check.
Is there any way to make this go faster?
Okay, so there wasn't anything in there at that point. Okay.
Hang on a minute. Let's check it again.
Look, all of these are locked, yes? And they've all got the lights off. This one's got its light on, so does that mean...
It wasn't locked.
He opened it on the way to go Detective Goodman's fingerprints to do.
He opened it in question with Detective Goodman's locker, sir. Is this a long shot? I don't know.
Objection, bitch! Regarding the video contained on this tape, there is one thing in particular that seems rather strange.
Strange?
This contradiction leads to the possibility that the man may not be Detective Goodman.
What? This video came such a contradiction?
Objection.
Interesting. Your Honor, I have a proposal.
Yes, Mr. Edgeworth?
I propose we have for defense. Point out to us this alleged contradiction in the video.
He would want me to point it out.
Right, well, proposal accepted. Let us further inspect this piece of evidence.
Let us look.
I will now play the security tape. Mr. Wright, please show us the contradiction you speak of.
I have to point out a problem in the video. Is there a time I've had to do that?
You can do it, Mr. Wright. It's set up so you can fast forward, rewind, or pause the video. Just take a good look and be sure to point out the right thing.
Please don't play it too many times. I can't stand watching this video.
How did this guy ever become a police officer?
Now then, Mr. Wright, please enlighten us. Where is the contradiction that indicates this man may not be Detective Goodman?
Oh my god. Oh my god, it's like Five Nights at Freddy's.
No, I didn't want to press there.
The thing that's strange about this video would have to be, this.
Hold on a second, I need to use my eye drops. Well, I don't get it.
Would you mind if I borrowed your eye medicine?
Don't let me have my blurry eyes.
Before your eyes get too teary, perhaps you should think this through again,
Now what do I do?
Play video again. What?
Let's try this again.
Just remember one thing, Mr. Wright. Every time you point your finger, someone gets hurt.
But he's not pointing his finger!
Bitch.
Oh no, right.
Come on!
Oh, see, I've got my cursor.
Stupid, creepy blue badger thing. This. Behold! The thing that's strange about this video has got to be this! Officer Meekins!
Sir! Did they mean me, sir?
As you understand it, the locker apparatus looks like this. When you grab the handle, a sensor is your fingerprints. If a print matches the registered data, the light turns on and the lock is released.
According to my very limited experience, that's the way I understand it, sir.
If so, then something seriously wrong with this picture. Wait for it. The light is on!
That means it's unlocked, does it not? Seriously, that would be a flawed system if only one person could get into it. Like, there should be a master lock or something, a master key.
When the victim reaches for a handle to open the locker, let's rewind to a little earlier.
Yes. Look, all these lights are off.
Don't want more, cause this is free light.
Here, notice a light.
Watch this, it's already lit.
Yes. Precisely my point, Your Honor. The locker was already open before the victim grabbed the handle.
Game over, dude.
Shut up, bitches. What's the meaning of this?
It's very simple, Your Honor. The locker wasn't locked on the day of a crime.
Wrong reaction. But the locker locks are controlled by an electronic system. When a door is shut, a sensor is triggered. And the locker is automatically locked.
Oh, I know. It must have broken down. Of course, I'm not an expert in this.
That's not likely, Your Honor. The sensor will detect and report any malfunction.
Oh well, it just goes to show an officer should keep their mouth shut. So then, Mr. Wright, do you have an explanation?
Me, Your Honor?
Yes, why was the locker locked?
Me, Your Honor? Yes, well, you see, this isn't exactly my field. What do you think, Miss Scientific Investigator?
Maybe something like jam the electronic system.
Something jam the sensor? Hey, there's something else that seems out of place in the video.
Yeah, I thought so too. There's got to be another clue somewhere in this footage.
Yes.
Very well, let's inspect the video once more. The locker wasn't locked. Mr. Wright, please point out the cause for this.
How come I thought do everything?
Okay, so look at when he opens it. I think a piece of paper drops out. There we go.
Nope. Here. Prison! Take this.
Shut up, timer. I'm busy doing a case.
I'm busy. Please watch closely. This is continuing with the part I showed you earlier. Behold.
If I can never stop playing that creepy song. Jesus.
Look at it.
Watch this. Something white fell out of a locker.
But sir, it's been my experience that things fall out when doors are opened. I often fall out and roll great distances when I open my...
Shut up! We can't be sure that item was in the locker to begin with.
What do you mean?
The sensor triggers a lock when the door is shut. What if something was inserted, say, between the sensor and the door?
Inserted? What does that mean?
I need a dictionary.
That belt, though. Jesus Christ. But seriously, it's making up that it's not going to be Detective Goodman. It's going to be someone some imposter.
Miss Whiteing wasn't inside the locker. It was stuck between the door and the sensor.
Oh, I understand now, sir. It's just like my tie. 2 out of 3 times it gets stuck in the door when I get on my patrol vehicle, sir. It's never door closing. My tie chokes me.
But the object would have to be extremely thin to fit in the door.
Not only that, it would also have to block electrical currents. It would need to be an insulator.
Yes, an insulator. But have a crime scene?
There just might have been something that fits the description.
But sir, by insulator, you don't mean...
I think I finally got this figured out. I don't know what it is.
Very well, what offense, please present the relevant evidence. What was this insulator that was stuck in the locker door?
Indeed. What was this? Ah, rubber glove.
Behold. They found this near the locker. A thin rubber glove.
But we can't be sure of that. That wasn't the victim's locker.
It is a tag that says SL9 incident. Oh. The video seems to depict the victim opening the locker. But that isn't the case. The lit lamp attests to this. On the day of a crime, even I could have opened that locker. Is that not so, Officer Meekins?
Sir, it would appear so.
Shut up, bitches! Okay. So, are we to believe in the victim whom this witness stabbed in the evidence room? Was not Detective Goldman?
Roger.
Do not be misled, Your Honor.
What do you mean, Mr. Edgeworth?
The defense has merely demonstrated the possibility and nothing more. The victim in the video was indeed Bruce Goodman. The prosecution will offer one more testimony to prove this.
What?
Officer Meekins, please testify about this.
Sir, I mean, sir. I'm not sure what you're referring to, sir. Oh, you mean that, sir? Of course, sir.
Is this a joke?
Very well, begin your testimony.
And we shall do this testimony in the next episode, so, yeah.
Thanks for this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.